Honorable Hussein Mohamed Dagane, member of Barrister County Assembly. I represent the youth on the floor of the House, as Article 55 suggests that the youth of this country must be associated or be represented in social, political, economic and other spheres of life.
There is a County Development Committee which is mandated for the actual implementation and authorization of disbursement of the fund to the target beneficiaries.
I am mandated by Article 185, the Constitution of Kenya 2010, that I shall come up with policies that will help my people, which is the youth now, because Garissa County, 60% of the population are the youth. I compel the county government through motions, through bills, through all the relevant policies that they should come up with programs that the youth will benefit in terms of sports. The county government department of youth and sports, they were very fast.
The award is called Leadership Excellence Award. I was awarded by International Christian Center in partnership with Ford Foundation after going through a lot of books on leadership and also the effort we've been doing on the ground, developmental, championing youth issues. I was actually the only person awarded from Northern Kenya the Leadership Excellence Award. I really like to appreciate the people who stood with me on this time, the youth of Garissa County, my family, and all the people of Garissa County. This is big thing for me and big thing for them, so I really say thank you so much.
One of the greatest achievements that I'm really proud of since I assumed office on this second phase of devolution as a legislator is the famous Revolving Fund, which directly funds young entrepreneurs. And without forgetting, pursuant to Article 195 on House committees, I also applaud the effort of the committee members of Trade, Tourism and Enterprise Development, who scrutinized tirelessly the document and came up with a clean copy of the Revolving Fund, which I'm the vice chair. This will enable the youth to borrow from the 150 million kitty to start or maybe to fund their existing businesses and return the principal amount they borrowed after a year, letting the expansion of the fund to the rest of the youth in the county. Yes, I championed the bill on the floor of the House from the first reading, second reading, up to third reading, including public participation, which is a constitutional obligation. Even the word public participation is mentioned 16 times in the Constitution. Challenges, yes. Women and Persons with Disabilities, MCS, who are also mandated by the Constitution of Kenya 2010 on Article 54 and 55 respectively, moving an amendment to the draft to include women and persons with disabilities to the fund. Was their right, and I agreed 110% so that we include them in the bid also. The bill is assented into law and supported by our governor, His Excellency Ali Bruno Korone, and we really appreciate the fact that he's youth friendly.
The county government department of youth and sports, they were very fast to make it successful to come with programs called League Mashinani. They also procured sport kits through their money. They also took part in Kenya Intercounty Youth Association, which they won. It happened in Eldoret, which they won all their way to the finals. The emerging of the seven side, it was through a motivation by the county government. We have three seven side pitches right now as we speak. The Ligi Mashinani is every team will represent a ward. They come to the main sub county, compete all their way to the finals. It basically means the essence of devolution is service closer to the people. Now what we did is that the youth were tired of the county of only used to play on the town and then that's it. But what we did, what the department did was they go all the way to the wards. They play through quarterfinals, through the knockouts first of all, the quarterfinals, the semifinals, then the final happens in every sub-county. Then all the sub-counties now come to the main quarter, the headquarter, which is now Garissa, and the best takes the day. And Garissa has no any modernized pitch, but every youth and every civil servant or anyone who wants to take part in football has now the opportunity to come to seven side pitch. The need was felt because we don't have as much as it was in the manifesto of the government. We don't have, we cannot say we don't have a pitch or a football place we can play. So I would like to congratulate the private developers who listened to the cries of the youth in the county that came up with pitches called the seven side pitches. We started with San Siro, the main one, now is in Garissa. Now these other two came up in the county. And that one, it helps the youth because most of the people, some of the civil servants, some of the state officers were shy about playing on the field with the kids. But now, seven side pitch is more of a developed, on a modernized field that anyone can be part. There were no opportunities from the beginning before we came into power. There were no policies anyone fronted because, as you know, in the Constitution, a member of the public can petition the county assembly to come up with a policy. No one did that, and we were a bit in the dark before. And I think also the resources of the county were limited because they prioritized health or maybe education first and then sports. And football, it just became some kind of a sport that used waste time. The parents never thought sports is something meaningful. So whenever you play football, you're going to have a rough time with your father. The parents see it as a joke. Kids from Garissa in the first time to come from Garissa and go all the way to La Liga. Season 3 of Chapadimba, it was great. The whole matches, the whole knockouts, I was there. People came all of the way from Wajir, Mandera, Garissa, making now Garissa the hub of all the headquarters of Northeastern Province. One of the two players now who are awarded the best player and the striker is the same guys who were taken by Chapadimba Safaricom to Barcelona, to La Liga, the giants of Europe leagues, to come for the first time in history to witness one of the matches with Barcelona. The mother and the father of Khalid are very proud. Their son was the first person ever from the northern part of our country to visit in Barcelona. So those kind of opportunities, it sensitized the other youth. It encouraged them now to work hard. Chapadimba has made it very clear that any person who has talent can take part, can go anywhere in the world. Garissa was the first ever pastoral summit to be held in Garissa. That was the first person, because they see Safaricom is doing Chapadimba season 1, 2, and 3 in Garissa, where the huge crowd come and they get hotels, they accommodated and all. So it's also an opportunity for Garissa. And Chapadimba has brought, could be Khalid, the one who visited Barcelona, could be playing in Barcelona one time, could be playing in the biggest club in English, could be playing in Liverpool, could be playing in Arsenal. You never know. Chapadimba has united the region through sports, and we would like to tell them, never get tired of us until we stand on our feet.